Thank you. Father, Spirit of Truth, who art in heaven, present and cast all things, treasure of things, and all of great glories and glimpses of all of purity, and save our souls of our fear. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill among men. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill among men. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise.
It is time for the Lord to act. Bless, Master.
Blessed is our God always, Lord, ever and to the ages of ages.
Pray for us.
May the Lord direct your steps.
Remember us.
May the Lord remember you in his kingdom always.
The Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above, and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. Of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy temple, and for them that with faith, reverence, and the fear of God adhere herein, let us pray to the Lord. For our great Lord and Father Kirill, the most holy patriarch of Moscow and all Russia, and for our Lord, the very most reverend Hilarion, Metropolitan of Eastern America, New York, First Hierarch of the Russian Church Abroad, for the Venerable Priesthood, the Diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this land, its authorities and armed forces, and for all who with faith and piety dwell therein, and for the God-preserved Russian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and in the diaspora, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That he may deliver his people from enemies, visible and invisible, and confirm in us oneness of mind, brotherly love, and piety, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city and country, and for the faithful who dwell therein, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for seasonable weather, abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for travelers by sea, land, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the imprisoned, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be delivered from all tribulation, wrath, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have
remembrance our most holy, most pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, Theotokos and Deva Virgin Mary, and all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God.
Yeah.
holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another in all our life unto Christ our God.
Let us sit on the word and sing. Savior, glorious in thine arising.
Christ, come and save us all.
our God, and unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever.
O Lord, save the pious, and hearken unto us.
O Lord, save the pious, and hearken unto us.
And unto wages of
Hallelujah.
Peter, the bringer of the good tidings of the holy apostle and evangelist Matthew.
Vega, through the intercessions of the holy, glorious, all-praised apostle and evangelist Matthew, give speech with great power unto thee that bringest the good tidings unto the fulfillment of the gospel of his beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Wisdom, aright, let us hear the holy gospel.
Peace be unto all.
The reading is from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew. That time when Jesus departed thence, two blind men followed him, crying and saying, Thou Son of David, have mercy on us. And when he was come into the house, the blind men came to him. And Jesus saith unto them, Believe ye that I am able to do this? They said unto him, Yea, Lord. Then he touched their eyes, and saying, According to your faith, be it unto you. And their eyes were opened, and Jesus straightly charged them, saying, See that no man know it. But they, when they were departed, spread abroad his fame in all that country. As they went out, behold, they brought to him a dumb man possessed with a devil. And when the devil was cast out, the dumb spake, and the multitudes marveled, saying, It was never so seen in Israel. But the Pharisees said, He casteth out demons through the prince of the devils. And Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues and preaching the gospel of the kingdom, and healing every sickness and every disease among the people.
Peace be unto thee that bringest the good tidings.
Glory.
Let us all say with our whole soul and with our whole mind, let us sing.
Have mercy.
O Lord Almighty, the God of our fathers, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to thy great mercy. We pray thee, hearken and have mercy. Again we pray for our great Lord and Father, the most holy Patriarch Kirill, and for our Lord, the very most reverend Metropolitan Hilarion, first Hierarch of the Russian Church abroad, and for all our brethren in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray for this land, its authorities and armed forces, and for all who faith and piety dwell therein, and for the God-preserved Russian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and in the diaspora, and for their salvation.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray to the Lord our God that he may deliver his people from enemies, visible and invisible, and confirm in us oneness of mind, brotherly love, and piety.
Lord, have mercy,
Again we pray for our brethren, the priests, priest monks, and all our brethren in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray for the blessed and ever-memorable Holy Orthodox Patriarchs, for our pious kings and right-believing queens, and for the founders of this holy temple, and for all our fathers and brethren, on to the rest before us, and the Orthodox here and everywhere laid to rest.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
O physician of souls and bodies, with compunction and broken hearts, we fall down before thee, and groaning we cry unto thee, heal the sicknesses, heal the passions of the soul and body of thy servants, the Archpriest George, the Archpriest Michael, Subdeacon Matthew, Cassinia, Natalia, Maria, Maria, Daria, Catherine, the reader Isaac, Helen, Anastasia, Paul, Alexandra, Hope, Kosara, Sophia, Hope, Mary, Nina, John, Anna, Silca, and Nina, and pardon them, for thou art kind-hearted, all their transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, and quickly raise them up again from the bed of sickness. We pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord.
Again, we pray for those who are being persecuted for their faith, especially the Christian faithful in Little Rock, Syria, Palestine, and across the Middle East, that the Lord God will send down upon them every spiritual weapon to endure their tribulations, and that he will grant that peace which passes all understanding upon the region and throughout the whole world as a foretaste of his heavenly kingdom.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray that thou mightest look down with a merciful eye upon the people of the Ukrainian land and make her unconquerable by those who work strife. We pray thee, O kind-hearted Lord, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray that thou wouldst enlighten with the light of thy divine wisdom the thoughts of those darkened with hardness of heart, and fortify thy faithful in the Ukrainian land, keeping them unharmed. We pray thee, O Almighty Creator, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Thou who hast given us thy commandments to love thee, O our God, and our neighbor, make hatred, hostility, offense, graft, and the spilling of blood to cease, that true charity might reign in the hearts of the people of the Ukrainian land. We pray thee, O our Savior, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for them that bring offerings and do good works in this holy and all venerable temple, for them that minister and them that chant, and for all the people here present who ate thy great and abundant mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord.
Merciful God art thou, and the lover of mankind, and unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Jesus Christ, our God, look down with thy merciful eye upon the sorrow and greatly painful cry of thy children abiding in the Ukrainian land. Deliver thy people from civil strife, make to cease the spilling of blood, and turn back the misfortune set against them. Lead unto sanctuary those bereft of shelter, feed the hungry, comfort those who weep, and unite the divided. Leave not thine own flock to abide in sorrows on account of their kinsmen to diminish, but rather, as thou art benevolent, give speedy reconciliation. Soften the hearts of the unmerciful and convert them to the knowledge of thee. Grant peace to thy church and to her children, that with one heart and one mouth we may glorify thee, our Lord and Savior, unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Pray, catechumens, to the Lord.
Lord,
be faithful to the catechumens. Let us pray that the Lord will have mercy on them, that he will catechize them with the word of truth, that he will reveal unto them the gospel of righteousness, that he will unite them as a holy Catholic and apostolic church.
They also with us may glorify thy most honorable, majestic name, for the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
As many as our catechumens depart,
remain, as many as are the faithful, again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Wisdom.
For unto thee is all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, the good estate of the Holy Church of God, and the union of us, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy temple and for them that with faith reverence the fear of God, we may be delivered from all tribulation, wrath, and necessity. Let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Wisdom.
Let always, being guarded under thy dominion, we may send up glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
great Lord and Father, Kyrill, the most holy Patriarch of Moscow and the Russia, our Commander of the Holy Trinity, St. Sergius Lavra, and our Lord, the very most Reverend Larion, Metropolitan of Eastern American New York, First Hierarch of the Russian Church Abroad, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
This land, its authorities, and armed forces, and the Orthodox faithful that dwell herein, the God preserved Russian land and her Orthodox faithful, both in the homeland and in the diaspora, the Orthodox faithful of the suffering Ukrainian land, and the Orthodox faithful of every land. May the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
The clergy, the monastics, and all that are persecuted and suffer for the Orthodox faith, the founders, benefactors, and the treasures of this holy temple, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
The aged, the infirm, the imprisoned, those who are bedridden or absent with fault, and all you Orthodox Christians, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Sacred diaconates, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom.
Keep us, O God, by thy grace, that the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless. Let us ask of the Lord. That angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord. Pardon and remission of our sins and offenses, let us ask of the Lord. Profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord. That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord. Our Christian living to our life, painless, blameless, and peaceful, lend a good defense before the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask. Calling to remembrance our most holy, most pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, Theotokos and Deva Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God.
Through the compassion of the begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thine all holy and good and life-creating Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Peace be unto all.
And to thy spirit.
Let us from one another that with one mind we may confer. Wisdom, let us attend. Let us attend that we may offer the holy oblation in peace.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God the Father and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you. Let us lift up our hearts
unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto the Lord. Shouting, crying aloud, and saying,
oh,
This is my body, which is broken for you for the remission of sins. Drink of it, all of you. This is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Of thine own, we offer unto thee in behalf of all and for all.
We offer unto thee this ration and the daily service, and we ask of thee, and we pray thee, and we entreat thee, send out the Holy Spirit upon us and let us get saved.
Send down thy most holy Spirit at the third hour upon the apostles, taken not from us, O good one, but we do give in us, who pray unto thee, that make one heart of God, and that Holy Spirit with
you. Lord, we send down the most holy Spirit at the third hour upon the apostles, taken not from us, O good one, but renew him in us, who pray unto thee.
Among the first, remember, O Lord, our great Lord and Father, the most holy Kirill, Patriarch of Moscow and all Russia, Reverend Archimandrite of the Holy Trinity, Saint Sergius Lavra, and our Lord, the very most Reverend Hilarion, Metropolitan of Eastern America and New York, First Hierarch of the Russian Church abroad, whom do thou grant unto thy holy churches in peace, safety, honor, health, and length of days, rightly dividing the word of thy truth.
And grant unto us that with one mouth and one heart may glorify him thy most honorable and majestic name, of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever. and unto the ages of ages.
And may the mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with you.
Having called to remembrance all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the precious gifts offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord. That our God, the lover of mankind, having accepted them upon his holy and most heavenly noetic altars and odor of spiritual fragrance, will send down upon us divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray. Tribulation, wrath, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. That the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord. Guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord. Pardon and remission of our sins and offenses, let us ask of the Lord. Things good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord. That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord. Blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask. Having asked for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God.
And thou save us, O Master, that with fullness and without condemnation we may dare to call upon thee, the heavenly God as Father, and to serve.
Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be unto all.
Bow your heads unto the Lord.
Together with thy most holy and good and life-creating Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Let us attend.
Holy things are for the holy.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
daughter of Jesus.
Thank you.
Thy servant depart in peace, O Master, according to thy word. For mine eyes have seen that salvation which thou prepared before the face of all people, a light of revelation for the Gentiles, and the glory of thy people, Israel. Master, according to thy word, for mine eyes have seen that salvation which thou prepared before the face of all peoples, a light of revelation for the Gentiles, and the glory of thy people Israel.
Thank you.
with the fear of God and with faith and love drawn nigh.
I confess that thou art truly the Christ, the Son of the living God, who camest into the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief. Moreover, I believe that this is truly thy most pure body, and this is truly thine own precious blood. Wherefore, I pray thee, have mercy on me, and forgive me my transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, in word and deed, in knowledge and in ignorance. And thou save me to partake without condemnation of thy most pure mysteries, unto the remission of my sins and life everlasting. Amen. Of thy mystical supper, O Son of God, receive me today as a communicant, for I will not speak of the mysteries of thine enemies, nor will I give thee a kiss as did Judas, but like the thief do I confess thee. Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. Let not the communion of thy most pure mysteries be unto me for judgment or condemnation, O Lord, but unto the healing of soul and body.
Amen.
Thank you.
is now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Of the divine, holy, most pure, immortal, heavenly, and life-giving, fearful mysteries of Christ, let us worthily give thanks unto the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Having asked that the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God.
For thou art our sanctification, and unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Let us depart in peace.
Let us pray to the
Lord. O Lord, just bless them that bless thee, and sanctify them that put their trust in thee. Save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Preserve the fullness of thy church. Sanctify them that love the beauty of thy house. Be thou glorified by thy divine power, and forsake us not as hope in thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to the priests, and to all thy people. For every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, and cometh down from thee, the Father of lights, and in ages and in glory and thanksgiving and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory to God for all things. Today we heard, and today's Gospel, we heard again about the examples of faith, the importance of faith, and love, and not only what our Lord said and what our Lord did. In the beginning of the Gospel, in today's Gospel reading, our Lord healed two blind men who came up to him and asked for healing, and they believed that they would be healed. And that was one thing, and that's what led them to our Lord. And it's because of that belief, our Lord took them away privately and asked them, "Do you believe that I can do this?" And they said, "Yes, yes, Lord." And then he answered, "Let it be done to you according to your faith." And this is very important, because our Lord is acknowledging to them and to us that we are participants in the grace that he gives us. It does not just happen. We have to want it, we have to believe in it, we have to trust that our Lord will help us. And the other example of faith that we have is the faith of those who took the demon-possessed man, who's also mute, to our Lord. Brought him to our Lord, and our Lord healed him. It's because of their faith, for the one who could not confess anything, who could not say anything. It's because of their faith that he was healed. Have you saw an example of the paralytic, the man who was paralyzed and was let down on a bed by the four of his friends? Again, it is because of their faith. And here too we have, it's because of faith of those who care about us. And I mentioned also that we have the example of love. Because those who love that demon-possessed man, they did not flee from him, they did not turn away from him. It was not the example of the man in the land of the Gadarenes, who was left to be out in the tomb. They asked if these people cared about him, probably family or friends, and they brought him to our Lord. And this is an example to us as well of love and the importance of having faith, the importance of showing love for others, having faith. And when we pray, you may think that our prayers are not, you know, prayers may not have that much importance, but if we believe, we have faith that our prayers reach our Lord, reach the ears of our Lord, and believe and have and trust that He hears them, then that's all we need. We need to just have faith that we need to keep praying and have that faith. As an example here today in the gospel. And when we're praying for others as well. Because just as those family members brought the demoniac to our Lord, we have to remember to pray for each other and trust that our prayers will be answered. We don't know how, but we have to trust that our Lord will hear them. And another thing that comes with receiving great gifts is thankfulness. The two blind men were given their sight, and they could not contain it. Even though they were told not to by our Lord, they spread the news of His mercy, of His generous, of His wonderful gift to all the world, or to all the region. And this is something else that we should keep in mind as well. Another example for us, brothers and sisters, to be thankful for everything that the Lord gives us. And also in today's Gospel, we should also keep in mind that despite the Pharisees claiming that our Lord cast out demons through the ruler of demons, it is important to note that in the Gospel, today's Gospel, that our Lord, it is written that our Lord went about teaching and preaching and healing, doing good, nothing evil. Because our Lord, of course, can only do good, but the important thing here is that despite their reproach, our Lord continued to heal the region, to teach and preach, and to show His love despite the rulers of the people despising Him. So, brothers and sisters, please keep these things in mind, the power of faith, the importance of love, and being thankful for all that we have, recognizing the gifts, the wonderful things that our Lord gives us. And of course, you know, if we love our Lord, if we have faith in Him, then we have to remember that when someone does us harm, someone offends us, just as our Lord shows love towards others, and continue to heal, provide that gift of healing that He did not have to. We too must make the effort to show love towards our neighbor and do everything we can to help them and to love them. Amen.
Bless you, Lord, dear, finding grace, grace, and love of mankind, always, now, and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Glory to the young Christ, God, our hope, glory to Thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Father, bless.
May Christ, the true God, who rose from the dead, through the intercessions of His most pure Mother, our Holy God, Holy glories and all praise apostles, the Holy glories prophet, forerunner, Baptist, Lord John. For the saints whose memory celebrate this day, the Venerable Sisoes, the great of Egypt.
New Harmer, Simon, Digital Rupa, New Martyr, Phineas, New Martyr, Theodore, the Venerable, Sisoes, and the Key of Days, all the Holy Church of Julian, all the Shans, from Martyrs of Marinus, and Martyrs of their children, Orthodox, and Abigail, and those who have Rome, Zerot, Cyrenus, Valentine, the Presbyter, and Asterius, the Martyrs, the Sars, the Deacon, Innocent, Felix, Hermias, Basil, Peregrinus, Rufus, and Rufinus of Apollonia, Macedonia, St. Quintus in Phrygia, Confessor and Wonder Worker, the Virgin Martyr Lucy, Martyr Rixius, and those with them at Rome, Martyrs Anthony, Lucian, Isidore, Dion, Theodorus, Plutonius, Arnosis, Papagus, and Satyrus, and others, of St. Glenn, of Kiev, of Venerable Monena, founders of Kilevi Monastery in Ireland, of the Holy Apostles, Archippus, Philemon, and Onesimus, Martyrs Apollonius, Alexandria, and Timothus, new martyr marks, of the new martyr, Cyril of Peladar, who suffered at Thessalonica, St. Barnabas, Elder of Gethsemane, and the Gethsemane seats, of St. Sergius Lava, St. Guar, Arma, Herman the Missionary, along the Rhine, of all the saints of the Barons, and Rada of Clavinage, of our father, Mother, Saint John, Archbishop, Shanghai, San Francisco, the Wonder Worker, and all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is good and loves mankind.
Amen.
Take place approximately 7 or 7:30 on Tuesday the 21st.
this coming Wednesday. Please note the different day this week. Wednesday, July 22nd, will be a Rosa baking day at 10 p.m. As always, for this labor as well, it's a pretty intensive effort. The more people we have on deck, the faster and easier it will go. So if you are able to contribute any of your time on Wednesday, that would be greatly appreciated as well. Please be advised that because of the vacation season and the fact that in August this tends to be our lowest month of attendance at the services, we will have but one vigil service each of the Saturdays in the month of August. The time will change as well. We will have those beginning at 5 p.m. rather, and they will all be by legal services. Also, on the occasion of the first two Sundays of August, on the 2nd and the 9th, we will have but one divine liturgy beginning at 9:40 a.m. For those of you who've been in the parish for a while, you will remember this as the old starting time for the Slavonic Towers. So once again, one set of vigils on Saturdays in August and one divine liturgy the first two Sundays as well. For the remainder of the month, the Sunday liturgy service will return to normal, 7:40 a.m. English and Slavonic at 10:10 a.m. A reminder also that Father Victor and his Matushka are away today and tomorrow in Lakewood, New Jersey. He's been asked to celebrate with his Beatitude Metropolitan Onufriy of Kiev and all of Ukraine, the newly installed Metropolitan of the Ukrainian Church. This is his Beatitude's first visit to the United States in this capacity, and our church organized the senior priests to come and welcome him on his first journey here as well. Father Victor will be back in the area on Monday, July 20th, late in the evening. Father Victor also asked that we announce that this year the date of the annual bazaar will be held the first weekend of October, the 3rd and the 4th. We will begin accepting book donations for that in mid-September. The last announcement that I want to make pertains to something that I don't think is in church with us today, but I think all of us know Antonina Sheldon for many, many years. She sang and danced at the annual bazaar this year. This is her 84th birthday as well, so if we could also intone for many years on behalf of Antonina, that would be a wonderful thing as well.
A prosperous and peaceful life, health, salvation, and good success in all things. Grant, O Lord, unto thine handmaiden Antonina, and preserve her for many.
Power to my soul, for faith and shame, for love of fame, for the fulfillment. Shame on the age of the creator failing the same
Wisdom, most holy Theotokos, save us. Worthy, O Christ, God, our hope, glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, to the age of ages, amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Father, bless.
May Christ, the true God, who grows in the death of the innocent, let us know that your mother, holy, God-bearing, follows all the saints. Have mercy on us and save us. For he is with the mother, man, come on.
Amen.
Congratulations to all the good men of the Holy Spirit.